Senate Judiciary Committee Chairman Dick Durbin is asking Supreme Court Chief Justice John Roberts to testify before Congress. According to The Hill, Roberts is facing pressure from Democratic lawmakers to investigate details surrounding the undisclosed transactions and free trips Justice Clarence Thomas has taken, which were reportedly paid for by Republican billionaire and donor Harlan Crow. Democrats on the judiciary panel have expressed support for a, quote, binding code of ethics for SCOTUS justices, which, according to The Hill, Roberts did not welcome back in 2011.
In a letter to Roberts, Durbin wrote, "There has been a steady stream of revelations regarding justices falling short of the ethical standards expected of other federal judges and, indeed, of public servants generally. These problems were already apparent back in 2011, and the court's decade-long failure to address them has contributed to a crisis of public confidence. The status quo is no longer tenable. The time has come for a new public conversation on ways to restore confidence in the court's ethical standards. I invite you to join it, Politico reports." Durbin said Roberts' testimony on ethics issues would improve public faith in the high court. Senator Lindsey Graham weighed in on the matter, saying, "I would support his decision not to come if that's what he wanted to do," The Hill reports. So, what do you make of this? Should he come and testify or not?
I just feel like this is all a big to-do about really nothing. The ethics standards have only changed very recently, so a lot of these so-called free trips and things that were happening before Friends were not things that he would have necessarily been required to report in the past. And it's pretty common among SCOTUS justices to have friends in high places. I mean, Ruth Bader Ginsburg, if you were looking at some of the travel that she went on with Friends, we didn't really have the same reaction to that when she was alive. Because these people obviously don't get paid. They're not able to have the same level of income that perhaps politicians have or are able to make after they leave Congress. So they end up becoming friends with these people who are able to sort of treat them in these ways. Now, obviously, there's always going to be the question of whether or not this is influencing their ability to be judicially impartial. But that would be a question we would have to ask of every justice on the bench, mm-hmm. not just Clarence Thomas.
No, absolutely. I agree with you on one point, and that is that the ethical standards have just kind of been written when it comes to the gifts. And I think most people on the left don't think the gifts were the biggest problem. You know, it's not about what happened in terms of, you know, him taking him on vacation and things like that. It was the financial transaction that occurred over the land where he got paid, the real estate. That, of course, dates back to the Nixon era when you had Abe Fortas, who got $20,000 from a guy named Wolfson, who was a guy on Wall Street. I know it's kind of funny, Wolfson, Wall Street. Right, exactly. But he got that money. He actually gave the $20,000 back, but he was still forced off the court. And when we look at what other federal judges have had to deal with in terms of their ethics, Clarence Thomas not disclosing that is an actual issue. I was with the whole thing about him going on a trip with his friends and even using the private jet. You're allowed to have friends. You're allowed to travel with your friends. If your friend wants to pick up the bill, pick up the tab, that's one thing. It's different when you don't disclose a financial transaction. In addition to that, Harlan Crow has had some business before the court. Mm-hmm. Not directly, but he certainly funds organizations that actually do have business before the court and actually have done business before the court. So could there be some influence peddling? I will say that Clarence Thomas has always been Clarence Thomas in terms of his politics, at least since he was, you know, in law school. So It's not that I think that Clarence Thomas, this may have changed some of his views. I don't think he was a liberal justice and then got some
and
money.
And then Harlan Crow took him on a trip and he was like, all
and
right
then. And then all of a sudden he changed. But that is, in my view, an ethical violation based on what we kicked other justices out for in the past. And and the fact that he should have disclosed the financial transaction. He says he lost money on it, but it doesn't matter. You still have to.
Yeah, I mean, so he's amended his form, and this is not uncommon, again, for SCOTUS justices to amend their filings. Ketanji Brown Jackson has had to do it. Ruth Bader Ginsburg has had to do it. She didn't report the sale of a stock, for example. So, I mean, this is, I just don't think it's as big of a deal as it's being made out to be based on the historical precedent for it. Mm-hmm. And even ProPublica, which first reported on this lack of disclosure, didn't even write a follow-up piece about the amendment or claims like they some major victory against Clarence Thomas. So I don't even think that they are propping it up as this major ethical violation that it's been made out to be in the rest of the press.
Again, I think it's all about the rules. First of all, we need to iron out more rules, and that's why I think Chief Justice John Roberts needs to go before Dick Durbin in the Senate and talk about the rules and the ethical rules for the court, because I think it's not right that you have someone who has a lifetime position for the right, who always talks about, and people like Lindsey Graham, who talk about the three-letter organizations and the bureaucracy and the unelected bureaucracy. You have basically people who are unelected who have a lifetime position, and they're kind of given free rein to do what they want. And I think that that's really problematic. They need to iron these rules out a little more. And Chief Justice Roberts needs to go before the Senate and talk about what the rules actually are for Senate, for the SCOTUS justices. But I think we can see that this is a violation. And again, based on historical precedent, based on the fact that Abe Fortas was forced off the court for $20,000. Again, $20,000 in the early 70s was a lot more money.
Yeah.
But, he actually gave the money back, but he was forced out by the president, pressured him. Other justices on the court pressured him to vacate his seat on the court. And we see that if this happened to one of the lower federal courts, that person would have been, had a serious reprimand or even had to leave the court. And I think that to let just the really powerful judges, the nine of them, get away with things that we would punish some other federal judge around the country for, I think sets a really bad precedent. And it's against what a lot of conservatives are saying about these, the three-letter organizations, the unelected bureaucracy.
I'm all about rules being applied equally. I would say here's the deal that I would want to make. If mm-hmm. Chief Justice John Roberts is going to come testify about the new ethics rules, then I also want an update on the investigation into this leaker of the Dobbs decision, because what's going on with that?
No.
We still don't know who that person is. I mean, there's only so many likely suspects, right? So let's do both at the same time. Let's kill two birds with one stone.
No, I hear that, but also we have to remember that Alito was talking about that at his private dinners and talking about what he was going to do in terms of Dobbs and abortion altogether. So the leaker could be Alito.
It could be Alito.
You know what I mean? Which is really kind of interesting.
Well, that would be fun. I don't know. Let's do it.
Yeah, I mean, all of them need to be held accountable. And I'm not just saying that about the conservative justices. I'm talking about if Ketanji Brown Jackson does this, or Elena Kagan, or Sotomayor, if they are, sitting there and getting money and
for sure. Everybody has to disclose.
I think
we're in agreement on that.
Yeah.
All right. Great discussion. More rising after this.